batters haven't played since 2005. As Stover takes the snap over the middle, he's got Thompson, and the penalty does not matter. Ryan Stover finds Matt Thompson anyway. A 20-yard touchdown pass, and the Cardinals take the lead. Pistol John Lee to the left of Ryan Stover, Khalif Lee behind him. They will hand off to Khalif Lee, and Lee breaks the tackle and still going. And now Khalif Lee off to the races. 20, 15, 10, 5, and Khalif Lee with the 50-yard touchdown run. What a second effort from Khalif Lee. Ryan Stover with the snap. Pressure coming. Throws over the middle. Matt Thompson. And that is another Cardinal touchdown. The senior's second touchdown reception of the night. This one from 29 yards out. And the Cardinals lead it 20-0. Whistles and almost jumped off sides there.
Again, Tamir Bailey in motion. The give once again is to Khalif Lee. Khalif has a hole. He's at the 20. He's to the 10. He's to the 5. Touchdown, Cardinals.
Second down is a short distance. Under 2 minutes to go before halftime. Cardinals lead 6-0. Looking for more. Stover's pass is complete. That's number 2, Michael Sowers. And he's into the end zone for a Cardinal touchdown. Tamir Bailey in motion. Stover gets to Khalif Lee this time. Khalif bounces his way through a couple of defenders, and there he goes. That could be his second score of the night. 10-5, and he is into the end zone for his second touchdown of the game.
He just seems to have a number versus Wiz.
Over under center. It's number 3, Tamir Bailey in motion. Hands off to Khalif Lee. Up the middle, he's got a hole. He's got a first down, and he is in for the touchdown. A hat trick, back-to-back years against Wiz for Khalif Lee. Good job. Horn will take the snap and the pistol, hands it off, and that is another upper double touchdown. So Justin Horn with the snap, he'll hand it off to John Lee, and that's not Lee, that's Michael Cottom. Breaks the tackle, he's off to the races, cuts inside, and Michael Cottom is in for the touchdown. What a run!
Absolutely.
Over in the shotgun. To his left, going deep, he's got Thompson open, first down and Almore, inside the 10, inside the 5, and Matt Thompson is in for the touchdown, and the Cardinals respond, and they are right back in it. I feel like you're right back in it, because you got the ball.
Yep, so we're finally back out of the huddle, it's 3rd-and-1 from the 1. Stover gets, and is he into the end zone? Yes, touchdown Cardinals. That was number 26, Khalif Lee, with his first touchdown of the night.
Inside up from the 5. Again, Tamir Bailey in motion. They'll hand off to Khalif Lee again, and Khalif Lee pushes his way for an upper double touchdown. And once again, the Cardinals strike early and get an early 6-0 lead.
And Stokes pass, and he's going to go get it to number 2, Mike Sowers, and he's in for the touchdown.
Pass back to Khalif Lee, Khalif Lee is making a run, a great block there, and he makes his way, and it's a touchdown for Khalif Lee. Upper Dublin now is up 20-7.
Khalif Lee, over now, going deep in the end zone, he's got Gary Fields wide open, and the Cardinals might have just nailed the, put the nail in the coffin. They lead now 27-7. So now the Cardinals start at the 9-yard line. Short field for them.
Even better than they probably would have gotten if Cotton not had a big return.
That's definitely a strange play. As the low snap calls the coming to field it on his knee. So right up the middle goes John Wayne. And the first play from scrimmage for the offense. The Cardinals up on top early once again.
Talk about a good play to start the offensive drive. It only took one play, and John Lee scores our first touchdown of the night.
Lee up the middle is a huge hole, and John Lee will take it in for his second touchdown of the game. 13-0 Cardinals. Come out in a power formation. Hand off to again, Khalif Lee. Lee to the right side. Pushing his way, and he is in for the touchdown. Khalif Lee pushes his way in for a 10-yard touchdown. And the Cardinals now lead 19-0.
A possible concussion symptoms. We're not exactly sure, but we hope he's all right. Vikings will run the read option. It's fumbled and picked up for a touchdown.
Hey!
The Cardinal defense comes away with the turnover and they score themselves.
So no movement really. Khalif Lee once again, and this time he's into the end zone. Touchdown, couple minutes left in this fourth quarter and counting. This quarter will essentially be over in 12 minutes, maybe 15
times. Ryan Silver wide open to John Barry. And John Barry with the touchdown of 41-0. Cardinals are just cruising right now. Ryan Silver under center. That's number three, Samir Bailey in motion. They'll hand it off to Khalif Lee. Khalif Lee up the middle. And it is a touchdown for the Cardinals. Only a little over a minute into the game. And the Cardinals take the early lead.
Three. They get one play. And
he stopped.
Oh, what a play. He got in the half. As the Cardinal players rush to the locker room with huge momentum after that goal line step.
And the half.
Wow.
9-yard line.
Over with two backs behind him. And Tier Valley once again in motion. And they give us to Khalif Lee. Khalif to the 15, he's to the 10, 5, touchdown Cardinals! Khalif Lee with his first touchdown in two games!
They can't stop him!
Absolutely, an amazing season, a perfect record in the conference. Their only loss coming in week two to Abington. This has just been an amazing football team, and it's been an honor to cover them.
It really has. We are definitely excited next week. For the first time in school history, they will host a playoff game. To Khalif Lee, and Khalif Lee is close to the end zone, and he is in for the touchdown, and the Cardinals strike first. They lead 6-0 halfway through the first quarter. What a start for the Upper Darwin Cardinals. 3:20 to go in this first quarter. Cardinals lead 7-0, and they're looking for more. Indians showing blitz. Ryan Silver will hand off to Khalif Lee. He's got a huge hole to middle, and Khalif Lee makes it a 13-0 game. What a start for the Cardinals. John, goal at the 1. Cardinals looking to pound it in and take a 3-score lead. Stover will sneak it, and he's in for the touchdown. 20-0 up for Dublin. It's all Cardinals here in this first half. The Pokey injury and a punt away. And they're going to fake it. They've got a first down and a lot more across the 40, 5, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, and it's a touchdown.
Yes.
A touchdown, a big punt, and the Cardinals stunned Carroll Rock. It is now 27-0. What a play.
I did not expect that one. Stacy Gardner, he said he was ready for tonight's game.
He sure was.
I'm getting my lead messed up. Here's the gift to Khalif Lee. Khalif across the 30, east of the 40, cuts back in midfield, into Council Rock territory, and there he goes! 20, 10, 5, touchdown Cardinals! Woo! A hat trick for Khalif Lee! Second goal for the 4. We only got one shot, so let's make a count. It's a takedown, nobody can stop us now. Stand up, shout it out, sing loud so the world can't drown us out. Khalif Lee. Part, let's leave a mark. Touchdown. 4 touchdowns for Khalif Lee.
That's it. Our lips don't make a sound.
We march with feet on sound. So Ryan Stover will hand it off and up the middle for another up and up one touchdown. That's Evan Scott. And the Cardinals keep pouring it on now. It's 47-14.
Pretty much no win to speak of, which could benefit the pass game. They're going to hand off this time. Lynn's going to play action now. Stover wide open is John Bennett. And the Cardinals respond with a touchdown of their own. It is now 7-6. The play action fooled me that time in a full Rochester's defense.
Fourth down as we open up corner number 2. Hand off to John Lee. John Lee gets the first down. And a lot more. John Lee into the end zone. And the Cardinals respond with a touchdown. 14-13 with the extra point to Joe Collins.
23-14. Rustin with the lead with the Cardinals inside the 1 yard line. 12 seconds to go. They will hand it off to Khalif Lee. Khalif Lee gets met at the line. Second effort, though. He gets it for the touchdown.
What a play from Khalif Lee. And with 7 seconds left in the half, the Cardinals cut the lead to 2 points.
Michael Sowers in motion. Calling in number 36, Harrison Cohen. Stover fires. Thompson. Thompson's going to get a first down and a lot more. Thompson still on his feet. He's to the 15. He's to the 10. He's to the 5. Touchdown, Cardinals!
Stover back to pass. He fires. The pass is caught by Matt Thompson.
Touchdown over that one. Matt Thompson with his second touchdown of the game. His second touchdown of the quarter. And up for that one. That's now put up 30 points on Westchester Rustin here in Westchester. Fourth and 9 for the Cardinals. If they get this fourth down, it might put the game away. Stover rolling to his right. Going deep. He's got Thompson. And make it 3 touchdowns for Matt Thompson. Pressure coming, gets rid of it, going deep into double coverage, and there it is, intercepted! And he will just take a knee. Guess who that is, John?
Oh my goodness.
Matt Thompson completing the game of his life with a game-sealing interception, and the Cardinals are going to the semifinals.
All right, 3rd and 2, and the Cardinals are at the Pensbury 7-yard line. Well, technically it's 3rd and goal.
And who was the ball that time?
That was an interesting play. We'll see what the call is. It's a touchdown!
Wow!
It's a Cardinal touchdown!
I had no idea! First set, they give it to Khalif Lee, and Khalif Lee with the second effort is close to the goal line, waiting for a signal. And he is in for the touchdown! Up for double now, 13-6. Khalif Lee scores his first touchdown of the night. I've been waiting for my dreams to turn into something I could believe in, and looking for that magic rainbow on the horizon. I couldn't see it until I let go, gave in to love, watched all the bitterness burn. Now I'm coming alive. Feeling my world start to turn, and I'll taste every moment and live it out loud. I know this is the time, this is the time to be more than a name or face in the crowd. I know this is the time, this is the time of my life.
get it, Rick. Hold on. Hold on. Let me get it.
Coach Dover, how does it feel to be conference champion?
It's an awesome feeling. It's been since 2010, so 4 years in the making. And this started last year at Abington in the playoffs when we lost. These guys committed themselves to the program and the cause, and they're reaping the benefits of it tonight, and I'm so proud of them. We'll be here in beautiful Cardinal Stadium on the new turf for the first ever playoff game here.
All right, well, congratulations, Coach. Great job.
Thanks for your time. Thanks for coming.
I'm here with senior John Lee. And John, how does it feel to be conference champion your senior year?
It feels great. I mean, first time ever outright. Nothing better as a senior.
John, what did it feel like to score the first two touchdowns tonight's game to really push the Cardinals to that conference championship?
It felt really special. I mean, it's senior night. No one would have had it any other way. We knew what the stakes were, so it was a really big touchdown.
And last question here. What was it like when you were running in the end zone against PW with 34 seconds left to give us the victory?
I honestly... There's just so many emotions. I can't even really remember it. I just remember turning around being sworn by the team. I mean, it was awesome. Best moment of football so far.
All right, well, great job this season. Good luck in the playoffs next week, John. I'm here with Matt Thompson. And Matt, how does it feel to be a conference champion?
It feels awesome, man. I mean, senior years, nothing great. Nothing better, dude.
Before the season, this team's goal was to win the title. So going to that PW game, we knew that was a big game. How did you guys concentrate on that game?
Well, I mean, we knew we had to win that game to win the title, and we really put everything we had into that one game.
Oh, bro, let me get on this thing.
Khalif, how does it feel to be conference champion?
Good. It felt good.
Amazing.
We never knew we could come this far, but we came this far, baby.
No one can stop us.
My lawyer's so good. My lawyer's so good that by tomorrow morning, you'll be working in Alaska. So just one.
Obviously, the Cardinals very pleased to be champions. What a season! I'm here with a bunch of Cardinals after the big win, guys. What does it feel like to win the first playoff game in school history?
I'm a real big fan. I'm a real big fan.
Feels great.
All for Sutton.
All right, what else?
Paul and Giddles at the games, man. Announcing, they're just doing a great job, and we just really appreciate it.
Hey!
My lawyer's so good. My lawyer's so good that by tomorrow morning, you'll be working in Alaska.
So just one.
I'm here with Coach Dover, and Coach Dover, all week we heard about how great of a quarterback Brandon McElwain was. How did you guys game plan to take him out of the game?
Coach Pring put together a great defensive package, and our kids went out and executed to the letter. We really didn't make any mistakes back there. We gave him a short field, and he took advantage of the one. But I'm so proud of the way the kids played, and so happy for these kids to be the team to get the first playoff win in school history.
Yeah, we really just dominated the game out there. It was a great effort from them. So next week we go to Westchester to face Ruston. What do you think about that game?
I don't know much about them. I know they have a really good running back, and they're the 3 seed. And we're excited to be getting on the bus next Friday night and heading to Westchester Ruston.
All right, well, thank you for your time. You. Yep. Great job, and see you next week, Coach.
Thanks, guys. All right, tomorrow morning we're going to be working in Alaska. So just one.
I'm here with Coach Dover. Coach, what a huge win for this school.
It is. It really is. It's a great win for the players and the school and the program and community. It's just great. Couldn't be happier. The for the players, man. They really played hard tonight. You know, jumped down 7-0 right off the bat, and they didn't panic one bit, and just very happy to be a part of this. Great ride.
Yeah, you guys were down about 2 at the half, and in the second half you just came out and destroyed Rustin. What did you say in the halftime locker room?
Nothing. It was very, very controlled and very, you know, we were very, you know, businesslike. You know, there's no panic in our team, and our kids came out and executed the adjustments from offense and defense, and saw the result.
All right, well, we'd like to thank you letting us get inside, and we'll see you next week for Pensbury.
Got it.
I'm here with seniors Matt Thompson and John Lee, and guys, what a game overall from this team.
Yeah, I mean, we came out seniors. This isn't going to be our last game out here, so we came in with that mindset, and we proved it.
Matt, I think you're, I mean, the whole team played well, but I think you're the MVP with 3 touchdowns and the interception. Did you know this was going to be your night, or when did you have that special feeling?
No, I made a mistake early, but I came back, helped my teammates, and that was it.
All right, well.
This big hunk of meat.
All right, well, great game, guys. We'll see you next week at Pensbury.